Ladies and gentlemen, here's the host of our show, Mr. Z, Jag Zakara.
Thank you very much, and welcome back to week four of Operation Brainstorm as we continue to move one team along and eliminate another. We have two new teams for you to meet this week, but before we do that, may I have our letters, please? Thank you very much. Better to be first than to be second. Dear Mr. Z, I am in first grade at Holy Name of Jesus School in New Rochelle. This is gorgeous print. I mean, you really have to see this. Absolutely beautiful job, I'll stand still, of handwriting by a first grader. I mean, I'm not that neat, okay? I am in first grade at Holy Name of Jesus School in New Rochelle, Mr. Z. In science, I learned how to grow a plant out of an onion, toothpicks, and a glass of water. My favorite subject is math. I watch your show every week and enjoy it very much. This is Miss Janet Brownstein from Petersville Road in New Rochelle. Janet, an Operation Brainstorm Achievement Certificate is on the way. In case you don't know what we're doing here, by the way, every letter we read at the beginning of each show, that student will receive a beautiful Brainstorm Achievement Certificate for what they're doing at school, as well as one of our really terrific Brainstorm t-shirts. It's on the way, Janet. Dear Mr. Z, I am in the first grade at Holy Name School in New Rochelle. I like reading the best. When I grow up, I want to be a doctor. I can tell because the penmanship's not exactly. I saw your show and I think it's a good show. Well, we think so too. Thank you very much. Someday, I hope to answer the questions. First grade from Mark Castillo, Cooper Drive, New Rochelle. Same school, two letters, two shirts on the way. Okay, let's show you how this thing works. Okay, we have a game board behind us, and there are six categories of academic disciplines. Below each category are point values. The higher the point value, the harder the questions. Our teams are going to take turns picking questions, and only the first person, the top person on each team, will try to answer by lighting their light first. Then we just keep moving contestants to the back. If they miss, lower point values are on the side of the board, and we'll give them a second shot at that. There are 20 minutes of regulation game time, followed by a 40-point bonus question, which very often decides our Brainstorm contest. Let's meet our two teams for today, shall we? This is the Sigma team, made up of
Joe Pacelli,
Trisha McMahon,
Jeff Kareem,
Joe DeMacy.
Okay, and we have a nice mic here, but you're going to have to speak up nice and loud for us anyway, guys and gals. And the Delta team, made up of
Joe Francisco,
Cheryl Moore, Becky Yeagle,
William Anderson.
Okay, let's speak up, everybody. Mary Ellen, if I might have a quarter, and if I might have the two captains here, William, we're going to give you the toss.
Heads.
Haven't missed in 4 years. Heads it is, Joe. William, your team gets to pick first. That's going to be you, Rebecca. Mary Ellen, if you'll start the clock, let's brainstorm. Okay, Rebecca, what category would you like to choose from?
Potluck for five.
Okay, a 5-point potluck question, which could be any area of academic discipline. And nice and loud, everybody, so we can all hear you. Potluck for five, it reads, a set of directions for preparing something to eat is called, for 5 points, Delta Rebecca.
Recipe.
A recipe. That's it. I follow recipes for things like boiling water and stuff like that. Jeff, category?
English for five.
Okay, a 5-point English question. We'll let you go right to the board also, and the question reads, indicate whether declarative, imperative, exclamatory, or interrogative. Please preserve our wildlife. Please preserve our wildlife. What is it, Rebecca?
Imperative.
Imperative is correct, Rebecca. Okay, Rebecca, if you'll move out, we'll get our two new folks to the top. And Cheryl, we're going to come to you, and you have a quick 10-point lead. And by the way, if I might direct everyone's attention to the top of our Brainstorm game board, we have a brand new game sign and category listing. Compliments of Ceruzzi Sign. So thank you very much, Ceruzzi Sign. How about a hand for Ceruzzi Sign? Yeah, why not? We're not proud, you know. They did us a great favor, and thank you very much. And you deserve a plug. That's really nice of you. Rebecca. Cheryl. Hi.
Spelling for 10.
Spelling for 10. 10-point spelling, if I might have the envelope. Thank you very much, Mary Ellen. Oh, yeah? Is that so? Could you lift the 10-point question? There it is. That's a star, which means that this is our bonus question for the day. There's the hidden star behind the board. So that 10-point spelling question is now worth 20 points, double point value. 10-point difficulty, however, and it says, please spell the word definition. Definition. A definition is simply the meaning of a word. Definition. Cheryl?
D-I-F-I-N-I-T-I-O-N.
Okay, and nice and loud next time. Shut down your light, please. You may have it for lesser point value. First light on that I see is Tricia.
D-E-F-I-N-T-I-O-N.
Okay, sorry. D-E-F-I-N-I-T-I-O-N. Definition was the word. Nobody got the points, but Cheryl, Tricia, you get to pick.
Social studies for 5.
Okay, before I see that, let's find out what's going on with you, kiddo. I've been going to the board for everybody. You're in the school play. Let's give it a plug.
It's Luann, and we're putting it on here, and it's going to be in March.
Okay, why don't you give the folks the date so they know when to come down here to Portchester Middle School to see Luann.
March 27th and 28th.
Okay, and what are you playing?
Darlene.
Darlene? Tell us about Darlene real quick.
It's Brad's girlfriend and Brad's Luann's brother.
Who's playing Brad?
Jeff Hudson.
Hi. Good-looking Jeff, huh? Okay, fine. Category was social studies, I believe, for 5 points. Let's see it. Name the holiday that is celebrated on the first Monday of September. Sigma Tricia.
Labor Day.
Labor Day is correct. Okay, 10 points, 5 points. Let's move it along, Joe.
Science for 5.
Okay, a 5-point science question, and the question reads, what is the name of the instrument that measures air pressure? Air pressure. That's kind of tough for 5 points, actually. 5 points, though. Air pressure. Time is out. Anyone may have it. Lesser point value, sigma. The first light I see is Joe.
Barometer.
A barometer is correct. There we go. And we're going to come to you, Joe, for the next pick.
Science for 15.
Okay, a 15-point science question, and the question reads, what is the name of the first antibiotic discovered? The first antibiotic discovered. Audience, I want to caution you against playing along out loud, okay? Be careful. Okay, sigma, and the first light I see is Jeff.
Penicillin.
Penicillin is correct, Jeff. Okay, we'll get two new people up to the top. Come on back up here, William. How are we doing on the score here? It's Delta 10 and Sigma 13. You have a big 3-point lead. There's about 5 minutes down in the game, so we only have about 5 down, about 15 to go. Hopefully everybody's a little bit more relaxed right now. William?
Science for 10.
Okay, a 10-point science question. We seem to like science questions all of a sudden. Let's see it. What is the unit of mass called in the metric system? The unit of mass in the metric system. The light is delta. Before the buzzer, William?
Gram.
The gram is the unit of mass in the metric system. Very good. Okay, 10 points gives them a 7-point lead. It's 20 to 13, Joe.
Social studies for 15.
Okay, a 15-point social studies question, and we'll go right to it. What is the maximum years one can serve as the United States president? And that was a very quick light, sir.
10.
10 years is correct. Okay, come on back up here, Rebecca. Huh, let's see. What's this about a band?
Well, me, Jennifer Carrillo, and Dana Filenko are going to start a band.
Three eighth grade girls?
Yeah.
What are you going to call the band, do you know?
No.
Okay, have any ideas?
No.
All right, good luck. What do you play?
I'm going to play the keyboard.
Keyboard. Let's go to this board.
Potluck for 10.
10 points. Potluck. Here's the question. What is the best reference book for locating voting statistics from the previous year? Last year's voting statistics. Where would you look? A reference book. Ah, there's a light on and I didn't see it. I'm so embarrassed. Jeff?
An almanac?
An almanac is correct. Saying, what are all those people pointing at back there? My goodness. Okay, Jeff, I'm sorry. Just kick me next time. I said next time, Jeff. He's a cute kid.
Science for 20 points.
Science for 20. I'm going to hang on to you for a second, wise guy. Stop that clock a second. What's this here? I get these little idea cards from the kids before the game. It says, loves computers, likes to eat, listen to Aerosmith. He's in the play Luann, and he hates the establishment. What's the establishment?
Any form of established government.
Would you consider yourself an anarchist?
Possibly.
Possibly. Does that mean you're a Democrat or a Republican? Never mind. I don't know. Okay, fine. I just wanted to check that out. Any form of established government, huh? Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, Rebel.
Science for 20.
Science for 20 from our anarchist. Let's see it. Name the three particles of an atom. Name the three particles of an atom. Three fundamental particles. I have a light, sigma. It's Jeff.
Proton, electron, and neutron.
Okay, very good. Come on, Rebecca, did you pick? Okay, so come on back up. You don't have to wait for me to kick you off the top, everybody. Just scoot back there. It's 58-20. They are sneaking away with a 38-point lead here, so let's go get them, Cheryl.
Potluck for 15.
Okay, a 15-point potluck question. We'll bring you right back in the game real quick. Let's see what it says. What is the permanent memory of a computer called? The permanent memory of a computer, what is it called? Time is out. Less a point value. Sigma. The first light I see is Joe.
RAM.
Sorry, Joe. Shut down, please. Less a point value? No. That was the after time was out. Okay. ROM. R-O-M. ROM. Trisha, back to you.
Social studies for 10.
Okay. Social studies for 10. He's holding his signs upside down. He thinks I can read upside down. Social studies for 10. Here's what it says. What country did Ferdinand and Isabella rule in 1492?
Spain.
There it is. Very good. Back when I was a kid. Come on up here, Joe. Okay. You're also in the play?
Yeah.
And what are you doing in our school play, March 27th and 28th, folks?
Playing Aaron Hill.
And who's that? And tell us what he does and what's up. Is that like Over the Hill?
Not really. Well, Luann, who is one of the...
You better stop the clock, I can think of it.
Luann, well, she's sort of likes me, okay?
And I don't... Sort of like?
I don't like her. Oh, well, I don't know if I do or not, but...
Are we talking Luann or are we talking Stacy who plays Luann?
Luann. Okay. Luann, yes.
I just wanted to get this straight. We're on television, you know what I mean? Go ahead.
It's about... And, well, I'm supposed to ask her to the dance, and she thinks I'm going to ask her, but I don't. And she gets really mad.
Can you blame her?
No.
Okay. Let's go to the game. Before I get you in all sorts of trouble, pal. Go ahead.
Potluck for 20.
Potluck, 20 points. Potluck is what we take when we talk. Go ahead. Who painted the Sistine Chapel ceiling? Who painted the Sistine Chapel ceiling? Delta.
Michelangelo?
I thought it was Benjamin Moore myself. 68-40. Joe.
Science for 25.
Science, 25 points. We got our lights down, and the question reads, last science question, what is the science of sounds called? The science of sounds. Sigma, Joe.
Rhythm.
Rhythm. Sorry, shut down, please. Lesser point value, Joe.
Radio waves.
Radio waves, shut down, please. Acoustics. The science of sound is acoustics. How are we doing here on score? No score, no point change there, so it's 68-40. We have a 28-point difference here, and everybody change up here to the top. So, William, we're going to come back. You had an interesting summer, sir. Why don't you tell us quickly about that?
I went to Skidmore College because I passed the test or got a high score on a college board SATs.
Okay, and what did you do at Skidmore College for a summer?
Well, I took European history for 3 weeks, and I made a lot of friends.
I used to love to spend my summers that way, actually, William, taking European history. Did you make a lot of friends? You keep in touch still?
Well, some of them don't write.
From all over the country, or?
Well, around Northeastern.
Okay, let's pick a category.
Potluck for 25.
25 point. Our last potluck. We finished science. We're about to finish potluck for the day. Let's see what it says. 25. Name one feature that makes humans stand out from other mammals. Oh, my. That light was already on. William.
An opposing digit or a thumb.
Other primates? Not opposable? Okay. Good time while we fight with the judges to take a commercial break, okay? 68-65, we'll be right back. Don't go away.
Hi, I'm Ellen Hilpel. I went to Fox Lane High. I am now a grad student at the College of New Rochelle. When I needed a student loan to further my education, I went to Village Savings. I received the funds in time for school. If you're planning on furthering your education, Village Savings can help you, too.
Let a Village Savings student loan help you with a high cost of higher education. Village Savings, with offices in Portchester, Rye Town, Pleasantville, North White Plains, and Bedford Village.
What does it look like?
Crazy, you're gonna get us in trouble.
Shh, don't worry. We do this all the time. Everyone does it, and the best parts, we never get caught.
Yeah, well, there's always a first time. Besides, it's illegal.
Here, just take one.
No, I don't take anything I can't pay for.
Look, it's only $1, and $1 to them is nothing. They'll never miss it.
No way. I don't want any part of this. I'll meet you outside.
All right, chicken.
Stealing by adolescents has become a major problem in our nation today. Most kids don't realize the cumulative effect that petty theft has on us all, and that most big-time thieves started out by stealing inexpensive items. Stealing's a crime against society, no matter how inexpensive the item may be. It's also a crime against your family for the embarrassment and hurt that they must endure. But probably most of all, it's a crime against yourself for the bad reputation, disrespect, and obstacles it creates in your life. So don't be a coward. Say no to stealing. Remember, it's your choice. You can pay for it now or pay for it later.
Okay, and welcome back. And I hope all our young people out there paid particular attention to that shoplifting commercial. We do find, unfortunately, that some of our youngsters do get in trouble once in a while, more so than they ever bargained for. So please, a word to the wise. The judges have reconsidered the last answer. An opposable thumb is not a purely human characteristic. Therefore, we have deducted those points, and I'm going to offer it, and you have not been allowed to talk for the last few minutes, I'm going to offer it to your team for lesser point value. So once again, please,
It is a characteristic that is purely human and makes them stand out from other mammals. Jeff, lesser point value.
Humans are knock-kneed.
Okay, well, the judges will vote on that one for about 12 years. I don't think so, Jeff. Thank you very much. They all just went to their Funkin' Wagnalls and started looking up mammals, you know. Knock-kneed. Okay. An enlarged brain and superior intelligence certainly would have been a proper answer for humans and other mammals. Good grief. It's 68 to 40, Joe. Get me out of this.
Social studies for 25.
Thank you. Maybe we'll be safe in social studies for a while here. Social studies for 25. The question reads, name the three factors that determine the standard of living of a country. Three factors determining standard of living. Joe, go.
Literacy rate, life expectancy, and annual income.
Very impressive. Okay. And it's 93-40. We've got some catching up to do, Rebecca. Let's go get them.
Spelling for 20.
Okay, and I should mention that we have about 8 minutes remaining in the game. Thank you, Mary Ellen. Come out here quickly. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. What's this? Who went to Amherst?
No one.
No one went to... No one has ever gone. Go away, Mary Ellen. Why do I bother? Okay, here we go. Spell hygiene. Dental hygiene is extremely important. Hygiene. Rebecca.
H-Y-G-I-E-N-E.
Yes. Thank you very much. Nice and loud. Our judges are having trouble hearing you, hon. Okay, but there you go. That's very good. It's 93-60. Here they come, Jeff.
I would like English for 10, please.
You asked so politely. How could I resist? He would like English for 10, please. Indicate the subject or subjects. Rebecca and a friend want information about cars. Subject or subjects, Jeff?
Rebecca and her friend.
Rebecca and her friend. We're both subjects. Okay. Shut down, please, and let's bring Cheryl back up to the top. And they come back with another score. It's 103-60, Cheryl. Still, however, a full 7 minutes remaining. Lots of high point values on that board, so this game can go anywhere. Let's not start waving any white flags here. Let's go get them, kid.
Spelling for 25.
All right, there you go. That's what I like to see. She wants a 25-point spelling question. Nobody noticed that. Don't worry about it. Trade you. Thank you. Afraid to come out. Man, huh? 25 points. Please spell fictitious. A fictitious name is not someone's real name. Fictitious. 25 points. Watch your time limit. I see a light. It's Delta. Cheryl.
F-I-C-T-I-C-I-O-U-S.
Sorry. Shut down, please. Lesser point value. Shut your light down, Cheryl. Thank you, dear. Lesser point value, Tricia.
F-I-C-T-I-S-H-O-U-S.
Sorry, dear. Fictitious. F-I-C-T-I-T-I-O-U-S. Fictitious. Let's move it right along. It's 103-60. Tricia, make a game pick.
Social studies for 20.
20 points. Social studies. Our last social studies question of the day reads as follows. The county seat of Westchester County is... It's not a chair, I swear. The county seat of Westchester County is... Lesser point value, sigma, first light I see is... Jeff.
White Plains.
County seat of Westchester County. These are teenagers. They don't know that it's any good for anything but the Galleria. What's the matter with you? How could you ask that question? Joe.
English for 15.
103-68, Joe. English for 15. And here it is. What two things does the word setting refer to in literature? Two things that the word setting refers to in literature, Joe.
Where it takes place.
Sorry, the answer's got to be there when the light's on. Shut down, please. Lesser point value prevails. Jeff.
Setting is where something takes place and the setting of the type.
Sorry, Jeff. Shut down your light, please. Place and time. Place and time.
Okay, moving right along. Did you pick that one? Then I'm coming to you, pal. 111.60.
Math for five?
Math for five. I will remind you there's a 40-point bonus question. By the time somebody picked the math question, let's see it. Put the following fraction into simplest form, 16 over 20, or 16 twentieths. Sigma Joe.
Oh, wait, two fourths?
Sorry, shut down, please. Lesser point value, William.
Four fifths
is correct. Okay, folks, once the light's on, game rules say answer's got to be there by the time I get to you. 111.62, 4 minutes remaining, William.
Math for 25.
Math for 25. Watch your score. There's a 40-point bonus question, everybody, so play according to the score. 25 points. Let's see it. Find the value of X. 2/3 X is 12. Watch your time limit. Light, Sigma, Joe.
18.
That's it. Tough one, huh?
Math for 20.
Okay, now that you got the 25, you don't feel so bad about picking the 20, huh? I see. Okay. Everybody left math for last. Let's see it. Subtract 0.001, 30001 from 1. Light, Sigma, Joe.
0.9999.
Yes, 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 yes. William, I believe you picked, so we're going to get Rebecca up here real quick. We have about 2.5 minutes remaining in a 156-62 game. You need some heavy points quick.
English for 25.
That's the only way to do it, kiddo. You might as well go at him. English for 25. Here's what the question reads. Punctuate and capitalize. Now, said Ralph, let's start eating. Beating the mom with the light, huh, Jeff?
Capital N and now, capital R and Ralph. Oh, I mean, let me punctuate first. Okay, capital N in,
Sorry, Jeff. Shut down, please. Got to have the answer there. Lesser point value. He started, so lesser point value delta. And it is Joe.
Capital N now, comma after now, comma after Ralph, quotation marks before let's, period, and then quotation marks.
Sorry, sir. Quotation before now, capital N, comma after now, close the quotation mark, said, comma, Ralph, capital R, Ralph, comma, quotation marks, let's, front and back, start eating, period, close the quotation marks. Oh. Okay, Jeff, you're picking?
English for 20, please.
English for 20, please, he says. Let's see it. What does the suffix OR mean? State of being, result, one who, action, or state? The suffix OR, Jeff?
One who.
One who. That's right. As in dictator. Okay. Cheryl.
Spelling for 15.
Spelling for 15. Just about a minute remaining in the game, folks. For 15 points, please spell restaurant. Mr. Kirsch had a restaurant that burnt to the ground. Restaurant.
R-E-S-T-A-U-R-A-N-T.
Restaurant. Think I'm kidding you, huh? Tricia.
Math for 10.
Math for 10. Excellent choice. Let's see it. Round the following to the nearest cent. $32.486. Cheryl?
$32.49.
And 49 cents. Come on up, Joe. We can get another question off here. Go ahead. Didn't pick the question. Don't get to do it. 176.87. Bonus question will not make the difference in the game. However, it would make the game a lot closer. So let's go for it here, shall we? Anyone may answer the bonus question, not just the top person. It's 40 points to either team. Anyone may give it a shot. Let's see the bonus question.
On a certain map, 1 inch is equivalent to 24 miles. How many miles apart are two cities that are 2.5 inches apart on the map? Delta, first light I see. William.
60 miles.
60 miles is absolutely correct. Okay, which brings us to a very respectable final score, 176-127. However, we do have a winner, and it's Sigma. How about a hand? Okay, congratulations. Good game, really. Everybody, boys and girls at home especially, at the beginning of the program, we read some letters and gave away some certificates and shirts. Please, if you'd like a shot at it, write me a letter here at Porchester Middle School. Write to Mr. Z, care of Porchester Middle School, Bowman Avenue, Porchester, New York, and the zip is 10573. Tell me what you're doing at school and what you've achieved, and if we read your letter on the air, we'll send off a certificate and a T-shirt to you. Thank you, panel of judges, Mrs. Singh and Mr. Nostro and Mr. Ryan, as always. Boys and girls at home and right here in the audience as well, please remember, you've got to learn it to earn it. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.